Okay, so I got something in the mail. It's actually a beta product. Doesn't look that interesting, does it? Now, what it is, basically, is it takes this and this and kind of combines it so that you can play it, as if it were like a Shield Portable type thing. So you have a gigantic tablet. Looks kind of weird, but it may, using it at home, nobody will stare. Especially if you're not, if you're by yourself. So you'll be the only one staring. So what are we doing here? So again, this is a beta product. It's called Utorcase or something, and it's specifically designed for the Shield controller and the Shield tablet. May work with other 8-inch devices, 8-inch tablets. But yeah, so how this goes on first, the Shield controller. I wouldn't attempt trying to put the tablet on first. So first you put this over the top like that. This is very flexible. You just pull that like that. There are screw holes in the back of the controller that this sets itself into. And you can just pop that in. And then there's this latch here. This latch likes to kind of come undone sometimes. It's not quite perfect. Like I said, it's a beta product, actually. So, that's that. Now, once you do that, you got that, and then you have the tablet. So this is the holder for the tablet. Make sure that your tablet is facing upwards. Another problem with this is that this seems a bit loose. It seems like it could be smaller. Like, I don't feel like it should have just fallen in like that. It doesn't seem to be a problem in real world use, but the silly stuff, like, they show them on their website doing stuff like shaking it and stuff and turning it upside down and all that. And I attempted that. Luckily I caught the tablet because it almost hit the floor. What happened was it fell, well, not only shaking it, but no, what happened was I hit the touch screen, actually. I was trying to do something with the touch screen, and I hit the touch screen on the bottom. And it actually, I ended up pushing this out, like, because it's not, there's not much here, and it ended up just pushing out somehow, and it fell, and it was a little rough. So, that's that, but hopefully they can perfect this idea. So this is what you basically have, is the controller and the tablet together. Then you can turn on your tablet. Right now, I need to be careful because, like I said, this is a beta product and the dimensions aren't perfect. This is very weighty, like the weight balance isn't very good. I did mention to the guy who's making it, you should probably get it up a little more because it's giving too much weight backwards like this. It's just pulling like this. It's kind of uncomfortable to use like that. So it would be nice if he kind of angled it up a little more so that it didn't have so much weight pulling down on it. Also turn the controller on, and then there are, they make other cases, other finished things like this as well. They also make one for the Nexus 7 and the Shield controller, because you can use USB. So you'd be able to use USB to the Nexus, the old Nexus 7. But yeah, so I played a few games on here as well. New little thing. And try to, me see if I can zoom out a bit. Nope, not in, out. I guess not. So you can. And now, the difference between something like this and, say, the Ipega 902, blah, 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 whatever. 9023, 903, whatever. This thing, the telescopic controller thingy. Now, you know, this, I really like this thing. But a reason you may want something like this is because, A, you like the shield controller. Maybe this is a little bit too, you know, a little rough trying to play like this. And it bends a little bit. It doesn't have, you know, like real analog or whatever. It has buttons for triggers. It doesn't have the same exact compatibility as the shield controller. Even though it has really good compatibility, it's not as good as the shield controller. You'll have to map your emulators differently depending on the controller that you're using. So if you want to use this, you have to go into the, you know, you have to change the inputs depending on what emulator or whatever you're using. This doesn't work. Like the select button is an actual select button. And like the NVIDIA uses the back button. What that does is, well, actually, that could work in your favor. If you're not really wanting to share features, you could actually probably use that in stream games that require long pressing the select button. But, you know, apparently people have issues because some games require you to long hold the select button and you long press the back button. Because instead of having a select button, it has a back button. So you long hold the select button, or the back button, and it pulls up the dialog for all the sharing features, whereas this doesn't have that. But with this kind of thing, you only need one controller. You need this controller, all the compatibility is very good, and you don't have to remap emulators and all that stuff. Yeah. The only thing is, putting it together is a pain in the ass. Putting this thing on the controller, and then on the tablet, and everything like that. And apparently we're playing Darksiders 1. I don't want to play Darksiders 1. I don't. Okay, let's quit Darksiders 1. I prefer the second one. But yeah, we have all the grid games you can play, and, you know, that I mean, they're kind of too long to start up, but yeah, you see, you can play your games. You know how the controller works with the tablet, but that just holds it in place, and you'll be able to play games like that. But like I said, this thing needs work. That's why it's in beta. So let me just pull this out. Okay. So this is also 3D printed, by the way. This is from, what is it, Shapeways. Kind of like shapewear. I hope my mailman doesn't think I'm wearing shapewear. Oh my god. He does. But he'd be right, you know, I am. Anyways. Oh! Nothing happened. I don't think you'll have a problem if you drop it. It'll be fine. It is very flexible. I don't want to flex it too much. I'll probably fucking break it. But, you know, it's very flexible. Has to be. And you can tell it's 3D printed by feeling it. In fact, I've never actually even felt a 3D printed object before. But I have watched videos on how that's all done, and from multiple videos, and once you feel the object, I'm like, okay, yeah, this is 3D printed. So, yeah. But yeah, this is could be probably adjusted. Like I said, this could be a little from here to here, and probably from here. You know, at least this could be shorter, and this length is too long because it's not holding it completely. It needs to be tighter. And this latch, maybe this latch could be a little, like, this piece could be, like, thicker somehow. so that it doesn't fall out, because what happens is it just falls right out, and it's this way it normally falls out. So if you made it thicker, it probably would stay in place still, but it's the exact same thickness as this, and there's not really anything. It doesn't snap into place or anything. I don't know. No, if you can make it, maybe make it snap into place, but that always falls out. But for the most part, it works in real world usage. You can sit on my couch and use it, and it's all right. So, but yeah, that's that. The Utorcase for the Shield controller and Shield tablet, beta product, not finished product. So, yeah. Thanks for watching.